Siema, Gostosny Każdy wraz z odcinkiem F1 2016. Zapraszam do oglądania.
Welcome to Japan and the impressive Suzuka track for today's qualifying session, where we should be underway shortly. This is the kind of track that eats rear tyres for breakfast, or so I'm told by more experienced drivers than myself.
Well, tyre management is key here, specifically the rears. It's all too easy to overheat and wear the rear tyres as they're punished out of the low-speed corners. Most teams won't be able to avoid some kind of issue here, especially the teams that are running less downforce.
Chance of rain now. If the situation changes, we'll let you know.
history.
Set then for the race tomorrow. But before we go, let's quickly remind ourselves of our top three, who are Ricciardo, Hamilton, and Kimi Raikkonen. With quality. We'll be right back.
very warm welcome to the Japanese Grand Prix, an event that has decided a driver's championship 11 times over the years and has hosted some very memorable races as well. Who can forget Kimi Raikkonen's win from 17th on the grid in 2005 or Kamui Kobayashi's incredible drive to a podium in 2012. A lap of this historic racetrack covers 3.6 miles, and it's the only time during the season that we race on a figure of eight racetrack. The drivers can expect some intense G-forces through the 18 corners on offer here as they experience some of the highest average apex speeds on the Formula One calendar. And keep an eye out for overtakes going into the final chicane. And all this will be happening under the watchful eye of Anthony Davidson, who joins me for today's race. And assuming the weather holds, where do you expect to see the action unfolding today, Ant?
Well, most of the time, parsing here is limited very much into the final chicane, or maybe down into turn one if you get a good run and some assistance from DRS. But if we're lucky, we might see a bit of bravery into the hairpin, a place that Kamui Kobayashi certainly made his own in the 2010 Grand Prix on his way to a very impressive seventh place. And as you say, Crofty, this is all assuming that the conditions hold out. We know how quickly the clouds can come in here at Suzuka, and if they do, all bets will be off.
Okay, watch out at the race start. There will be faster cars trying to get past. See if you can hold them off.
So before the off, let's remind ourselves of yesterday's qualifying session with a look at the starting grid. It was a good showing from Red Bull in qualifying, and Daniel Ricciardo starts from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Raikkonen, Rosberg, Felipe Massa and Verstappen, Hülkenberg, Vettel, Bottas and Jenson Button, Perez and Sauber, Daniel Kvyat and Gutierrez, Ericsson, Alonso, Romain Grosjean and Carlos Sainz, Palmer and Magnussen, Rio Haryanto and Pascal Wehrlein completes the grid. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
attention, your eyes pulled me under.
to the car ahead is 1.1 seconds. switching to an alternate strategy? Do you want to change or stick to plan A? Lewis has punctured a tyre. He'll be coming in this lap.
Incident in the next pass of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags, so the gap to our teammate
is 34.9 seconds.
Mercedes today, that's another historic win. Tell me, what was the key to this success?
The difference was clearly in the strategy. You can tell they've done a lot of work on the pit wall to really optimise each stint and get the most out of the tyres. And it highlights just how much of a team sport this really is. But credit to the driver as well, though. There's no good having a well-oiled machine behind the scenes without a talented hand on the wheel, of course.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. And now I'd like to ask you, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
From my point of view, it would have to be the Sauber driver. They demonstrated a very delicate touch in close proximity to other cars, as well as showing a lot of maturity and patience in difficult situations.
And now let's take a look at the constructors' standings. Mercedes have extended their lead at the top of the standings. There'll be plenty more twists and turns to come this season. I hope you can join us at the next race to see just who will come out on top.
No i do następnego odcinka. Cześć!